Welcome to Ellicott City Church, oh. SDA Church.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome to church. Hi,
Father in heaven, as we gather here this morning, we have come, Lord, because we are a people in search of your love and your grace. Lord, we want to experience the presence of our God. We know that our life doesn't make sense without you. And so out of our great need, we come. And Lord, we're so grateful that the Bible pictures a God with his arms open wide. A God who is looking for his people. A God who wants to be among his people. And even through the power of the Holy Spirit to dwell in his people. Father, we ask that you would be with us in a special way today as we worship you. And while we have come to receive the blessings of being a part of the family of God, we have also come first and foremost to bless you, to honor you, to ascribe to you all the things, Lord, that make you the God of our life. We lift you high. Lord, we know that you are the answer to every need in our life and in our world in which we live. We wait patiently for Jesus to come. Our hearts cry out for that day when we will be with you face to face. And as we gather on that sea of glass, on the other side of this world, Lord, may we lift our hearts in thankful praise to all that you have done. It will be because of Jesus and all of him that we could stand in your presence. And so be with us today as we worship you in humbleness and with spirit and in truth. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. I hope you'll take that white card that's located right in front of you. And if you'll take just a few minutes and share your experience of visiting with us on that card, we would be so greatly honored by that. And if you'll take that card and close the service out to the Welcome Center, we have someone there that would kindly give you a gift for you to remember your visit with us today. So I hope that you'll do that for us. It'll be a real blessing to us, and I know you'll be blessed too as you leave. Immediately following our service today, we're going to continue our fellowship with a lunch. We do this every time we worship together. So remember, anytime you find yourself attending our worship service, plan to stay by for the fellowship that continues. I know that you're going to have a great time. It's always a cause for celebration when the theme is haystacks. Can I get an amen? And if you don't know what that is, hang around. You'll find out. Hey, you should have noticed a giant banner when you walked through the door. I noticed since I wasn't here, some of our greeters didn't have on a button, but you'll notice a big banner there that says, Just Ask. Can you imagine the power of just those two words? Just ask. You know, it was the very question that I thought about when I was thinking about my wife, or my future wife. And that person is Zava. Zava came to church today, and because of her, has brought more people than anybody else here this morning. And so Zava and family, I want to invite you to come up.
And so her nickname is Ava.
I thought her nickname was Zava as well. Well, I asked Junitha, and Junitha knows everything. All right, come on over here.
And the mom is Dixie and Cream. Glad to have you here.
Amen. All right, well, this is a special day because, as you can imagine, anytime we get a young person in the arms of parents who come to the altar, it is a special day. I'm going to keep a little bit of my distance because I was around some other children last weekend, and one of them shared something they had. And in case you've noticed, I've been dodging everybody, so I certainly don't want to get anyone ill this morning. But this is a special day, and as I understand, you brought a number of your friends and family to support you in what you are doing here today. Is Ava your first child, or do you have others? Your first child. Oh, we're really going to pray for you. You have so much to learn. And God has given you the greatest teaching tool he could ever give to anyone. And that is a child. Isn't that true, parents? You really learn a lot when you have a a child. You learn a lot about God, and you learn a lot about your own need. I want to share a scripture that's very meaningful at a time such as this. It's taken from Mark chapter 10, verses 13 and following. And it says this, "And they were bringing children to him," that was Jesus, "so that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, 'Permit the children to come to me. Do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Truly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it at all.' And he took them in his arms and began blessing them, laying his hands on them." You hold in your hands a gift from God. He is the giver of life, and all life springs from him and belongs to him. Your child is on loan from God to you. He has chosen you and entrusted you to create the environment that will help Ava grow up to fulfill her potential in being a part of his kingdom. There is much that lies before her, many dreams and ambitions and aspirations that you might have. But I want to tell you the most important thing that you can do for Ava is to help her to learn about God, to demonstrate in your life, in your family, in your home, what it means to be a Christ follower. And so because of that, you have come here this morning, knowing that you cannot do this alone, that it takes help. It takes the help of others, and it takes the help of God. And so this church believes in ministries to families and children. We're committed to helping children and providing the kind of support that parents need to raise their children to love Jesus. From the smallest child, we provide Christian education through our Sabbath schools and programming in so many ways for her to learn about Jesus. We are here to encourage you and support you as parents and family in the most important part of the spiritual development of your child. And so, do you commit that together you will raise your child in a way that pleases God? By instructing them in God's word, by introducing her to Christ's love for her need of his salvation, by modeling godliness in your home and marriage, by protecting her from the evil influences, and by teaching her to rely on the power of God, and by regularly fellowshipping with other believers in a church family. If so, say we do. And as you dedicate this child today, you also dedicate yourselves to Christ, that you might live as an example for her. Yeah. And now, church family, I want to ask you the same question. It is a commitment. It is a deep commitment, because God entrusts to the church the responsibility of providing support and care and nurture for our young people. It's easier to have a church with no children. That's the easiest thing we could do, but that's not the godly thing to do. That we are a family, and we acknowledge that these are gifts that God has entrusted to us as well. And so you as a church, if you realize your responsibility to help in providing the kind of environment and experience that will help Ava grow up and one day come to this altar to accept Jesus as her Savior and to be baptized to be a part of God's family, amen, would you say we do?
We do.
We do. All right, I'm going to invite our leadership team to come up. If we have any visiting pastors, we'd love for you to come up as well. And we're going to surround the family. We want to pray for Ava and for her family and for her friends. We have a certificate that we're going to give to you in just a moment. We also have a letter that I have written to Ava that talks about what we did this day. And I hope that in the days to come, maybe on that very day when you talk to her about the plan of salvation, that you will help her to understand that this is her destiny. That long before she ever knew that she needed to make a decision for Christ, that you came to the altar and you offered her to the Lord and invited his presence and his power to work in her life so that that day will come. that God will bless you and keep you faithful to the promises that you have made and that you as parents have made. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for the privilege this morning of celebrating life and celebrating the goodness of God in our lives in so many ways. We want to pray especially this morning for Ava. We thank you that her parents have felt the call to bring her to the altar this morning to recognize that she is a gift from God and that she belongs to you, that she has a destiny to be in your family forever. And as they dedicate this child, as many others have done over the years, we're praying especially for the Holy Spirit to work powerfully in her life. As parents, we know our children are never far from our thoughts, that even though they may grow up and move away, they are always there. And so we are mindful that you remind us that you are our Father and that you have a heart as a father does. And so, Lord, we pray that you will bless her and keep her, that you will protect her in the days to come. We live in an evil world, but we pray that her home would be a sanctuary, keeping out the evil of the world. Father, we pray for the conversations that will take place in her life, that you will raise up people to come along beside her and encourage her and challenge her to live for God. We pray that one day she will give her heart to you, that she will choose to be a part of your kingdom forever. We pray for her family and her friends and all of those here that have committed to help in that process. We pray your richest blessings on her and this family and this church today. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you guys. Well, speaking of children, I believe it's that time when we, what a wonderful thing to do, give money to children. And that's what we do here. We give it to the children, and they give it to the church so that we might bless the kids. And so we want to invite the adults, if you will reach into your pocket or your purse, your billfold, your wallet, take out an offering, hold it high up in the air. We're going to have our young people come by in just a moment and receive that offering. And then...
Sabbath. We come to worship you. We come to praise your name. We come seeking guidance from you today, right now. Lord, we have things going on in our lives. Each one has something different, whether it's problems within our families, with our children, with us individually. It could be, Lord, that we have, and you know, could be that we have pains in our bodies. We know that the devil is attacking. He seeks to discourage us. Lord, we need you. We need your healing. We need your spirit in our lives today. Give us direction. We ask, Lord, that you would help us to draw closer to you. Help us, Lord, as a church, as a worldwide body, seek to share the love of Jesus with others. Increase that love in us by being within our hearts. Lord, we ask that if there's anyone that has anything physical that is causing a distraction in their lives to where they can't even pray, Lord, we pray that you will remove that according to your will. Give us the strength, Lord, to go forward. We ask that you would give us the strength and power to share the wonderful things that you've done in our lives. For Lord, it is a privilege to be here today. It is a blessing that you woke us up and brought us here. And we are praising your name. Lord, increase our hope. And that means increase our relationship with you. Prepare us for the coming of our Lord. For there's nothing else. There is no one else that can save us but Jesus. We need Jesus in our lives. Lord, I pray that you will be with Bruni as she is going to go through some tests soon. Pray that you will be with her. Comfort her and her family. Heal her according to your will. All of us, Lord, we have various things that are going on in our lives. We pray that you will bless us, meet our needs. Help us to have the faith and trust in you. Answer our prayers according to your will. Be with us as we continue to share this wonderful gospel, the gospel of salvation in Jesus Christ. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, to worship together. Bless us, save us in your kingdom. This is my prayer in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. We thank you for hearing and answering our prayers. Amen.
All day long I my song. Thank you. What was the title? The, on the Holy Ground? Oh, in the presence.
She likes the camera.